You may have suspected it already, but now the science backs it up. Unmarried and childless women are the happiest subgroup in the population, and they are more likely to live longer than their married and child-rearing peers, according to a leading expert in happiness. Now, according to a professor at the London School of Economics, evidence shows the traditional markers used to measure success did not correlate with happiness, particularly marriage and raising children. In fact, it boiled all the way down to this, quote, if you are a man, you should probably get married. If you are a woman, don't bother. Professor Paul Dolan says men benefit the most from marriage because they calm down, taking less risk, earning more money, and living longer.
As Kevin, usual. Women,
what do you think?
Women are taking care of you.
Was he on point or just completely wrong here?
I mean, I don't know. The stats back it up finally, right? It makes sense.
Well, you just got married about a year ago, right?
Yeah, my wife is watching at home.
Say the right thing.
We got married last year, and we're having a kid later on this year.
Oh, congratulations. Oh,
thank you.
So she's about to be really unhappy.
Yeah, she's a statistic here.
How about you? Are you happier since you got married?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Of course, she's watching, so what are you going to say?
The pressure is on. Yeah. You know, what about it? Break this down for us here.
Well, you know what? I'm married with children, but I do have a lot of friends that are single with no kids, and they're living their best life, right? But they do want to be in relationships, especially the females. But the males, I agree with the data.
You do agree with the data.
I agree with the data. The research, yes, I do.
Yes. God.
I've been married so long, I'm so calm, I'm about to fall asleep. Yeah.
Wake up, Todd.
It's interesting the way things have changed over the years, and I think they're going to continue to change as we go. I don't know how I can not agree with the statement about the women being happier not being married, because, you know, you kind of look at it from a different perspective and go, you know, there's a lot of pluses to being married and having the children. I mean, there's a lot of happiness there, so I guess it's just maybe a little bit more happy not being married and living your best life. It's like whatever you decide you want to do, whatever's going to make you the most happy. I think for some it's better.
The age change, too. Like when they're older, survey them when they're older and they have kids, the growing kids, and see how they feel.
When the kids are out of the house, you get happy again.
Yeah.
I guess it depends on what kind of kids.
Yeah, that's true.
All right. Well, new research finds that Facebook users under the age of 18 are spending less time on that platform. And it turns out it's the rise in online gaming that's the big reason for the drop. Researchers say many younger people prefer video gaming with friends to spending time on social media. In fact, the time many Americans spend on Facebook and Snapchat dropped last year. Experts say the only platform not seeing a decline right now is Instagram, which of course is owned by Facebook, so Mark Zuckerberg is still doing fine. I know you were concerned, Nina.
Yes. You know what? My son is a gamer. And I say he's a gamer, he loves to play Fortnite, right?
Oh, yeah.
And he does spend a lot of time playing it, but he's on social media less. So he feels that gaming is more rewarding because it's competitive. He's getting something out of it.
Well, and he makes friends all over the world, right? One of my sons used to do that and has friends in Asia.
Because he's like, I get on Instagram, but I don't care about the likes and comments.
Mm-hmm. Right.
He's very competitive with the gaming piece. So
Yeah.
All right, Todd, what about it? Does the gaming aspect surprise you at all?
No, it really doesn't. I was about to mention, and I don't know how many people will understand this, has Facebook jumped the shark? You know? Remember the old Fonzie, happy days, jumping the shark type situation? Because I know I have found I have been on Facebook a lot less, and maybe it may be because of the content that I'm seeing is no longer as relevant to me as it once was. That has changed as well. And I do spend a little bit of time on Instagram. I also have a son who's a big gamer, and I don't believe he spends very much time on social media at all. And then I have the daughter who's all over social media, but doesn't do the gaming. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I think there are different reasons why people want to be on there. They're different personalities for different reasons.
Right. We're talking about two very addictive things, playing video, Fortnite being the game, right? When you talk about video, when you say video games in 2019, you mean Fortnite. Everybody's playing Fortnite. So it's Fortnite and social media are very addictive in different ways.
Yeah.
And so they're spending a lot, because they're addicted to Fortnite, probably.
Yeah.
They're addicted to the video game. So what's better, being addicted to the social media or being addicted to the video game? They're interacting with people either way, in very different ways than we used to do. But yeah, I can see Snapchat's their decline is because Facebook stole all their ideas, and people.
So I don't know. Have you seen the gender changer?
Yes.
Have you done that?
Yes.
Did you make a handsome man?
I make a cute guy.
Honey, I look like Randy Travis with earrings.
You got to see these. Put these on TV.
Have you done this? We should do this. Maybe we'll do this next week. Oh yeah.
Yeah. This needs to be on. This needs to be online tonight. I need to see.
Okay. Yeah. You don't want to see that.
We will keep moving here. And Pokemon wants to turn sleeping into entertainment with a new app. 3 years after the Pokemon Go craze temporarily boosted Nintendo's value, the company reveals some new products. And Pokemon Sleep will now track the amount of time players spend sleeping and when they wake up. That information will then have an effect on the game that you play. The app is expected to launch sometime next year, Todd. So is this ingenious? Is this absolutely insane? What do you think about it?
I have to be honest with you. I'd have to sit down for probably an hour to try to understand what's going on. And you were mentioning earlier about the whole addictive. Fortnite was the one. So is Pokemon another one of these games that you would play
online? Remember, Pokemon Go was the one where you'd go and you'd try to capture these.
Okay. So what they're saying is that based on your sleep and the quality of the sleep will determine how much you're allowed to play on that game in the future?
I don't know. I think it's creepy.
Because it is. It's another one of those potential addictive things. And is this a good thing? They're trying to help kids say, no, you didn't get enough sleep. You don't get to play today.
they keep pulling you in, do they not?
Robot mom.
Yeah.
Come on, you're an expert at this game. Tell me more.
No, I'm not an expert. Well, I'm an expert at everything. But Pokemon, I don't know. I don't think they're trying to help anybody. I don't think that's what it is. They're trying to make money, right? And trying to get people addicted. All of these apps that they're out there. She said, absolutely, right? Mm-hmm. Like the word app. I don't want this. I don't have Facebook on my phone. I don't have Instagram on my phone. I don't have any of these apps that will track what I'm doing. I don't want anybody tracking what I'm doing. Not that I'm doing anything wrong. It's just like, let me be.
It's kind of creepy because I get in my car and it tells me how many minutes to drive to the place I usually go after work. And I'm like, whoa.
I don't remember asking for this.
Yeah, right, exactly. I want you to know where I'm going.
I have all the apps on my phone, but I do not want Pokemon Sleep because, I mean, I get very little rest and I don't think the kids will, this is something that they'll probably be into if it's trying to track sleep. Because they're up on these games.
You're right about that.
I'm interested to see how Pokemon Sleep does.
Yeah, or how they make money, how they monetize that, because that is what it's about.
All right, guys. Thank you so much. Good to see you all. Appreciate it.